जीदधामां प्रपद्यन्ते तां सथैव भजाम्यहं मम वर्तानुवर्तन्ते मनुष्या पार्थ सर्वशः. लॉर्ड कृष्ण सेज दैट एवरी मैन इज फॉलोइंग माय पाथ इनडायरेक्टली और डायरेक्टली. The supreme position of the Lord is that He is in the supreme absolute position. And every other living being, they are all subordinate. In the Vedic Upanishad, it is clearly stated, Nitya Nityanam चेतना चेतना नाम एका बहुनाम विदधाति कामा. दिस इज द नेचुरल लॉ इन एनी सोसाइटी इन एनी कम्युनिटी इन एनी कंट्री इवन इन द एनिमल सोसाइटी. इफ यू गो टू द फॉरेस्ट देयर आर सोसाइटीज ऑफ डिफरेंट एनिमल. Elephant society, tiger society, deer society, jackal society, wolf society, even in the birds, you'll find the birds of the same feather flock together. This is the natural way. You'll find that all the pigeons, they flock together. Not the crows and the pigeons flock together. The ducks, they flock together. Similarly, this is the natural way. And there in every group, there is a leader. So, the Supreme Lord, He is called in the Vedic literature that He is the Supreme Leader. Nitya Nityanam Chetana Chetanana. Nitya means eternal. And Nityana, that means many other eternals. We are many other eternals. Eka, that one eternal. Eka Bahuna Vidadhati Kaman. There are two kinds of eternals. We living entities, we are also eternal. And the Supreme Lord, He is also eternal. So far eternity is concerned, both of us equal on the qualitative nature. He is eternal and we are eternal. Satchidananda Vigraha. He is also all pleasure and we are also all pleasure. Because we are all parts and parcel of the same quality. So, but He is the leader. Eka Bahunam Vidadhati Kaman. That one is maintaining all these manies. We, the living entities, we are manies. So, our position is always subordinate. That is our natural constitutional position. Now, the Supreme Lord's position is the leadership and our position is subordinate. Now, then what is our duty? Our duty is to follow the leader. And actually, we are doing so. We have got, instead of, we have forgotten that the Supreme Leader is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But still, for our daily activities, we create a leader. We accept some leader and follow his principles. Just like you have elected your leader as President Johnson, the President of your state. He is supposed to be the leader of your nation and he is asking you to to go to the Vietnam and sacrifice your life. So you are following. But this is the natural position. Even if we do not accept God, even if we do not accept the leadership of God, we have to select another leader. We cannot get rid of this principle that we can live without leader. That is our constitutional position. So, the difficulty is that our difficulty is that instead of following the supreme leader, we are creating by mental concoction some leader according to our material conception of life, and we are falling. That is our position. So, Lord Krishna says, Je jathamang prabaddante tang sathiva bhajamaham momo vartvanu vartante manusya partha sarvasa. People are actually following the same principle. But the difficulty is that in our this position of lower nature, we are following in the manner which will not make us happy and satisfied. Because we are not following the supreme leader, the difficulty is. By constitutional position, we are to follow a leader. But because we are misled, because we are deluded to follow a leader which is not perfect, therefore our position is always unhappy, in spite of following the leadership of a concocted nature. Therefore, the best thing will be to get rid of this concocted position and follow the supreme leader. That is the highest perfection. Just try to understand that I cannot avoid following someone's leadership. That is not possible. Can anyone say that we can avoid this? No. We cannot avoid. Even if we don't accept the leadership of God, we have to accept some other leaders. That is our position. We cannot avoid it. So there is a very nice verse in the Srimad Bhagavatam. A Brahmin, he was a family man, just like worldly man as we are. Now, Brahmins are generally expected to be highly learned, and he was very learned man in Vedic literature. And when he came to his consciousness by reading all this Vedic literature, that although I am following the leadership, why I am not happy? Why I am not happy? This question should arise in the same human mind. One should think that I am following the leadership of somebody according to my position and according to my circumstances. But still, I am not happy. Why? Why we select one leader? The leader should be such a leader that they shall, he shall make happy and prosperous persons who follow him. That is the question of leadership. But actually, if we think in sober mind and cool head, we can understand that although we are following leadership, maybe whatever he may be, still we are not happy. Now the Brahmin concluded that this following leadership is the following leadership of my lust. I select one leader according to my lust. Just like in political parties, there are many leaders, but I like some particular type of political pursuit. Someone likes democratic political pursuit, someone likes Congress political pursuit, someone likes communist political pursuit. So we have got different desires. So practically, if we study very minutely, then we are not following the leadership, but we are following our particular lust. I have got a particular lust within me, and when I find somebody corroborating with that particular lust, oh, I accept him that leader. That is my position. Therefore, I do not follow anyone's leadership, but I follow my own leadership. That is the lust. I want to do, I like to do something, and if somebody says, oh, yes, it is very nice, so you are my leader. If you confirm my lust, then you are my leader. That is the material leadership. But the Supreme Lord is not like such, he is not such a leader. He is not going to follow your lust. In the Bhagavad Gita, you will find that the Supreme Lord says in the 18th chapter, Sarva dharmān parityajya māme ekaṁ saraṇaṁ vraja Ahamkaṁ sarva pāpibha mokhaśyāmi mā śuca. He says, my dear Arjuna, I have spoken to you all about Bhagavad Gita. I do not know whether you have understood the whole thing or not, but because you are my friend and I love you and you love me, I say you the most confidential thing to you. And what is that? You give up everything and just follow me. You just give up all your concocted things in the mind and just become Krishna conscious. Oh, I shall give up everything and simply I shall follow you. Yes. Oh, how can I do? I have got so many department of knowledge and department of things. How can I? No, he says, Ma Sucha, don't hesitate. Then what will be the result? The result will be, Ahankam sarvapapipha mokhaśyāmi. I shall deliver you from all reactions of your sinful acts. You know, of course, according to Vedic literature, and I don't say about the Vedic literature, that is the injunction of every scripture, either Bible, Quran, or any religious scripture, that we suffer due to our sinful actions. And our sinful actions are due to our ignorance. This is the cause. Now, you'll find in the Bhagavad Gita, Tesam satatajuktanang bhajatang pritipurvakam buddhi yogam dadamitam jinamam upajantite. Any person who is devoutedly, is attached to me and is fully Krishna conscious with love and faith, unto him I give dictation in such a way that he will come to me. He'll come to me. How he'll give me dictation? Oh, Isara Sarvabhutana Middesha Arjuna Tishtati. The Supreme Lord, by his plenary portion, is situated within your heart. Isara Sarvabhutana Middesha Arjuna Tishtati. That we, individual soul and the Supreme Soul, both of them are sitting in this tree of body. That is the Vedic injunction. The Veda says that two birds, just like friends, they are sitting on the same tree. One bird is eating the fruit of the tree, and the other bird is not eating the fruit, but is simply observing the activities of the other bird. This description we get from Vedic literature. The bird which is not eating the fruit of the tree, he is the super soul. And the bird which is eating the tree, which is eating the fruit of the tree, he is the soul. Individual soul. That is we are. We are sitting in this tree of body and we are eating. This body means every one of us has got a particular body for particular type of distress or enjoyment. Every living being is responsible for his past act and he gets a body, either human body or animal body, American body or Indian body or African body. There are different kinds of, I have several times repeated, there are 8,400,000 of different bodies. So living entity is, according to his work, he is wandering in this circle, in this cycle of different species of life. But the Supreme Lord, he is so kind and so friendly with us, that he is also with us. Suppose I am sitting in this bird, as soon as I fly to another, I am sitting in this tree, and as soon as I fly to another tree, the other bird, he also follows me. He also follows me and sits again in that tree. He is so friendly. Just imagine how much kind and how much friendly is the Lord. He's always trying to call me back again to him. We are trying to non-cooperate with him. We are trying to non-cooperate. And he is trying to cooperate. He is sitting with me in the same branch. He is witnessing, he is observing, and he is waiting, simply waiting. When we shall turn my face, when I shall turn my face towards him. That is the whole thing. So here Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavan Krishna says, Jedathamaṁ prapadyante. He is waiting, waiting. When you shall turn, when I shall turn my face towards him. That's all. He's waiting. Just you can imagine, just like a father and a rebel child or incense child. Those who have got, of course, you are all young men here. Those who are elderly persons, they have got experience. if their sons go wrong, how much they are anxious. How much the father is anxious to get his son back again. That is the natural instinct. And where from this instinct comes? This instinct comes from the Supreme. Because in the Vedanta Sutra, you'll find that everything, whatever you are finding in this material world, our spiritual world, everything that has come from the Supreme, Janmadasya Jataha, He is the supreme source, fountainhead of everything. So similarly, whatever we see, paternal affection, conjugal love, friendship, or master and servant, there are so many things we are related in this material world. We must always know that all these sentiments, they are coming from the Supreme. So here, the paternal affection which we see here, or the conjugal love which we see here, that is simply a perverted reflection of the Supreme. So, if we can study this material relationship between one living being to another living being, then if a sober student, a philosophical-minded student, can understand what is our relation with God. It is not very difficult to understand. Now here Krishna says, Jidathamang prapadante. He is looking after always when the living entity shall turn his face towards me. And as we turn our face toward Krishna, at the Supreme Lord, He also responds in proportionality. He also responds proportionally. It is not difficult. Somebody says, can we see God? Yes, you can see God. But how much? Prapatti, how much you have surrendered to God? Surrendered to God. How much qualification you have acquired for seeing God? Seeing God is not very difficult. But at the same time, it is very difficult. Just like if I want to see President Johnson, if I am unknown to him, I'll have to take so many formalities. I'll have to write to his secretary, and his secretary will give me some time, or may not give me some time, so many things. But if you are personally known to President Johnson, you are intimately thick and thin with him, and as soon as you call him, Mr. Johnson, I want to see you. Yes, you can come. So it depends on the thick and thin seed of your relations with Supreme Lord. If you can establish your relationship with the Supreme Lord, in love. The Lord does not require our cooperation. He is full in Himself. He does not require my service. But still, if you love Him, then He reciprocates. So our reciprocation with the Lord depends on the proportion of our love. Love of God. This love of Godhead can be attained by Krishna consciousness. The jidathamang prapadante, proportionately, as I surrender unto the Supreme Lord, we must always know that our background of relationship is that we are subordinate and He is great. God is great. we cannot be equal with him. We have to follow. He is the supreme leader. Therefore, Lord Krishna says that you give up everything. He is trying to give you leadership. He is prepared to give you all leadership, provided you are prepared to follow his leadership. That's it. Reciprocation. And in proportionately, as you accept his leadership, he also responds reciprocally. Jidathamam prapadha. As you, so everything depends on me. I can see God just like I am seeing you face to face. You are seeing me face to face. Similarly, you can see Krishna face to face. That's why Arjuna saw face to face. Why? Because the relation, see, was so nice that they were in friendly relation. So, the seeing of God is not very difficult. Simply we have to acquire that qualification. In the Brahma Sanghita, this is another Vedic literature, it is said, premanjana churita bhakti vilochanena santas sadaiva hridayeshu vilokayanti yam shyamasundaram achinta gunasvarupam govindam adipurusham tamaham bhajami. Premanjana churita bhakti vilochanena. Now, we have to prepare our eyes to see God. That's all. Just like we are seeing a thing, say, suppose a motor car, a layman is seeing, and another mechanic who knows how the motor car is running, what are the machinery, how it is fitted, he is also seeing. So, this layman seeing and the expert seeing is different. The expert mechanic, he can see the car, how, who has made it, who is the maker, and how it is running, and so many things he can see. A layman, he can see there's a car. So similarly, to see everything, just like we are seeing the sun, a child is seeing the sun, and a scientist, astronomer, is also seeing the sun. They're both seeing and not the same. So seeing God is not difficult, but we have to prepare our eyes. And how that eye is prepared, that is stated in the Vedic literature, that if you kindly smear your eyeballs with the ointment of love. There is an ointment, of course it is not available in the drug shop. You have to prepare that ointment. You have to prepare that eye ointment. Love ointment. And if you smear with that love ointment your eyes, then you can see Krishna always. Premanjana charita bhakti vilochanena santas sadaiva. Sadaiva means always. Always. Not a single moment you are without Krishna. Otherwise, do you think that, of course, in India we have got many sages. They are living in the jungle, aloof from human society, without any fear, without any caring the animals or for life or fooding. How? Because he is seeing always Krishna there. So he has no fear. He has no fear. He is enjoying life there. There are many instances in our life. One Rupa Goswami, Rupa Goswami, he was the Prime Minister of the then government. 500 years before, India was under the Pathan rule, Bengal, and there was a king whose name was Nawab Hussain Shah. Nawab Hussain Shah's Prime Minister was Shakar Malik. That Shakar Malik later on became a great devotee of Lord Chaitanya, and his name was transferred into Rupa Goswami. So they are coming from very aristocratic family, but they gave up everything and lived at Vrindavan, eating only dry bread and whatever nonsense. They were very rich men, but still, how they could live in such a way? Oh, that is described, that tattva tūrnamasi samandala patisraniṁ sadā tūchyava. They gave up all aristocratic association, just like insignificant. And tattva tūrnamasi samandala patisraniṁ sadā tūchyava bhutvā dīnaganeśaka karunayā kaupīna kanthāsito. And they adopt the life of mendicant, just to show mercy to the fallen souls. But how they live? Gopi bhava rasam mritabdhi lahari kallola magnau sada vande rupa sanatano raghujugo si jiva gopal. They were merged in the ocean of love of Krishna, and they lived so happily. That is, there is a position like that. That you can forget all these material comforts. There is no comfort in the material life. It is so-called. It is simply a delusion. We are thinking that we are comfortable, and suppose we are comfortable, how long you shall live in that comfort? That is limited. Either the comfort will leave you, or you have to leave you the comfort. It may be that your position, the comfortable position which you have created by your monetary strength, may be that your monetary strength may go down and you become a pauper, so comfort leaves you. Or if you continue, even if you continue a comfortable life, then death comes and you leave the comfort and you go out. So there will be separation, certainty. Therefore, the Brahmin of whose story I was telling, he, when after going through this Vedic literature, he understood that I am following the leadership wrongly of my lust. I am not following the leadership of anyone else. It is false. And although I am accepting somebody, my leader, but actually I accept somebody as my leader who corroborates with my lust. Therefore, lust created by me is my leader. So he says, kama dinang kotidhana kotidha palita dunnidesha. Oh, I have followed the leadership of my lust. And in doing so, I am ashamed to, accept it. I agree to accept it, that I have done so many nonsense by the dictation of my lust. Kamadinang kodidhana kodita palita dunnidesha. When a person is lustful, then he can do any nonsense thing. Lust is so strong. He can do any nonsense. Dunnidesha. Dunnidesha means the direction which I should not have followed, but being pressed by my lust, even I followed which I should not have followed. So he's just studying his own life, that so far I have followed the leadership of my lust, But the result is that my lust is not satisfied. Tesam natrapana nopashanti. A lust will never be satisfied. My lust is never satisfied, neither he is giving me release of this, slavery of my lust. So he says, my dear Lord Krishna, I have understood that I have followed the leadership of my lust so long, but the result is that the leader whom I have followed, neither he is satisfied, neither I am satisfied. Neither the leader is satisfied, just like, I'll give you a concrete example. In India, I know Mahatma Gandhi was the leader. But you know that at the last stage he was killed. That means the leader could not satisfy the public, neither the public was satisfied with the leader. This is the material leadership. Nobody can. We see so many criticisms of President Johnson. The other day I was seeing in the paper, they have given some caricature. So this is going on. Nobody is satisfied. Kamadinam kutidhana kutidha palita dimnidesha. I may follow the leadership of my wife throughout my whole life. Now, if I say to my wife, my dear, I am going to for spiritual culture, please give me leave. Oh, how can you leave? You have got so many responsibilities, you have this and this that. So there is no pension. So kamadinam kutidhana kutidha palita dunnidesha. Therefore, if we become saner, then instead of following this material leadership, we may agree to follow the leadership of Krishna. Just try to follow the leadership of Krishna and make an experiment how you are becoming happy. We have just started this association, International Society for Krishna Consciousness, and trying to preach Krishna Consciousness. If you kindly come and take advantage of this opportunity, it will be beneficial for both of us, because we have come here with a mission. And if you cooperate, you will be benefited. The Bhagavad Gita is a standard literature. Most of you know this Bhagavad Gita. But generally, the Bhagavad Gita is read very superficially, not very critically. We do not understand Krishna, the author of Bhagavad Gita. Neither we understand what is Krishna consciousness, although it is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. We read Bhagavad Gita superficially, not very critically. Neither there is any edition so far. Of course, in Sanskrit there are many editions. Annotation by Sridhar Swami, annotation by Baladev Vidyabhushan, annotation by Vishwanatha Chakravarti, annotation by Sri Ramanujacharya. There are many great scholars, but we have no information of those in the Western countries. We have no information of those scholars. Ordinary person with some academic career, they think that very learned, they can comment on Bhagavad Gita. Oh, that is not possible. That is not possible. The other day we have already discussed that Bhagavad Gita can be understood by a person who is Krishna conscious, nobody else. Bhaktosi priyosime rahasyam jeta duttama. So here is a chance. Now Krishna says that jidathamang prapadanti. Now the proportionately, if you agree to follow the leadership of Krishna, proportionately as you follow, so you become perfect. If you follow 1%, then you become 1% perfect. If you follow 25%, then you become 25% perfect. And if you follow 10%, then you become 10%. Krishna does not interfere with your individual independence. Every living entity has got an independence, minute, because he is also spiritual atom. We are all spiritual atom. That atomic, spiritual atomic force, just like material atomic force is so strong. So you can just imagine how strong is spiritual atom. In the modern age, the atomic age, the scientists have discovered the force, the power of a material atom. But they have not yet known what is the force of spiritual atom. There is spiritual atom. We are a spiritual atom. The atom is described in the Vedic literature, the form of the spirit, which we are actually. Kesagra satabhaga satadha kalpita sacha. Kesagra, kes means the hair, the upper portion of your hair. When it is divided into 10,000 parts, and just imagine that one part is the spiritual atom. It is so small, it is so minute, that it is not possible to see with our material eyes. Even the material atom also you cannot see. When the material atoms are combined into 6, then you can see and floating in the air through the sun sign which is entering your room through the holes of your window. You can see some particles. That small particles, there's combination of 6 atoms. That particle, when it is divided into 6, that becomes the atom. So you cannot see in the material atoms, and what to speak of the spiritual atom. When a dead man is there, the medical man and every scientist and everyone is sitting, how that spiritual atom is passed from this body, nobody can see. They can simply say, oh, now he's gone. Who is gone? Have you seen? Who is gone? No. Then what you are seeing? I'm seeing this dead body. So whole life you have seen this dead body. Now if I cannot see at the present structure of my body, even the spark material atom, how we can see God? The Supreme Spirit. So you have to qualify us. That qualification is, here it is said, it is stated, jidathamang prabandante. If you try to surrender yourself into Krishna consciousness, just like Krishna is canvassing, asking Arjuna, sarva dharmān parityajya māmekam śaraṇam. You just try to surrender unto me, and I shall give you all protection. And just I described a few minutes before, that Krishna is seated along with you in the same tree of this body. He's just waiting for your voluntary looking unto him. That's it. He does not place you. He gives you all instruction, just like Krishna gave all instruction of Bhagavad Gita to Arjuna. But at last he asked him, my dear Arjuna, I have given you all instruction, whether you have understood it, and how you are going to follow. Have you decided to follow me? Just see. He does not say that I force you to follow law. He asks him, now, have you decided to follow me? Oh. And he gives him the, I mean to say, full independence. Jathet shusi tatha puru. Now I have given you all an instruction. Now it is up to you. You can do whatever you like. So our position is always like that. Oh. Krishna, the Supreme Lord, all his bona fide representatives who come here, they can force you to go back to garden, but they do not do that. They want your voluntary cooperation. Unless you are prepared to cooperate voluntarily, oh, there is no question of my improvement. So we must accept our voluntary cooperation with Krishna, the Supreme Lord, or his representative who comes before you to canvass, my dear sir, please be Krishna conscious, please look to the leadership of the Supreme Lord. Now it is up to you. Now he says that actually they are following my leadership. Because they are servant, they are follower of some leader. They are servant of some created leader materially. That means that the propensity, that intrinsic background of following some leader is there. That you cannot avoid. That you cannot avoid. Mama Bhattvan Bhattante Manushya Partha Sarvasa. They have to, every man has to follow the same principle. He cannot go out of it. His constitutional position is to follow a leader. He cannot go out of it. Nobody can go out of it. He has to follow. Either A, B, C, B or anyone, he has to select. Just like, I'll give you another example. According to Manu Sanghita, our Vedic literature, the Manu Sanghita says, Nasyam satantatam arhati, woman should not be given independence. Or women are not independent. That is why I mean, truth, Vedic truth. Now, so far, a girl is child, he is dependent on the father, and it is hope, at least in India, we have got this principle, when a girl is grown up, the father gives her in charity to a boy to protect her, give her protection. And similarly, when a woman is grown up, old enough, she becomes protected by the grown-up boys, children. So this Vedic truth that woman has no independence, she is always under the protection, either under the protection of the father, or under the protection of the husband, or under the protection of the grown-up sons. That is position. And woman becomes happy in that way. Oh. Those who are not following this principle, I think, they are not happy. This Vedic principle is truth. So as the woman or the child requires the protection of somebody, similarly, by nature, we are under the protection of some leader. But that supreme leadership is vested in the supreme law. And when we do not accept the leadership of the supreme, then we have to accept somebody else, A, B, C, D, as our leader, and they misguide us. Andhadathandhirupone, how they are misguiding? Just try to understand. How our leaders are misguiding us? Just try to understand. In the Bhagavad it is said, Nati vidu sartha gatim hi Vishnu durasayade bahiratthamanina andhadathandhairupaniyamana stepi satantra urdham ibadhya. People deluded by the material nature do not know what is the ultimate goal of life. The ultimate goal of life is Vishnu. Vishnu means self-realization, the Supreme Soul. Why? They do not know it. Na durasayaje bahiratthamanina. They have accepted this external deluded nature as the goal of life. They want to be happy by adjustment of this material nature. This is durasaya. Durasaya means, a difficult, a far away. This hope will never be satisfied. They have made it a point to forget God for good, and they want to make it a point that we shall be happy in this material world by adjustment of our scientific or so-called knowledge. And the leaders who are leading them in that way, what sort of leader they are? Andha jathandhi rupaniyamana. Andha, just like a blind man. Sometimes you see a blind man is in this side of the street. He is asking somebody, kindly get me to the other side. But if another blind man comes, all right, I will help you. So what he will help you? The man who wants help to go to the other side, he is seeking for help, and another blind man comes, all right, I shall help you. That help will, that in the middle of the street they will be smashed. Both of them will be smashed. So similarly, our leadership is like that. Our leaders, they are compact by the laws of nature. And they are proclaiming that I am leader. Just like in India, our the late Prime Minister Shastri, he was leader. He went to, Russia, for making compromise with Pakistan. But he did not know that while signing the peaceman agreement, he would be expired. Andhadathandhi rupaniyamana stepi isatantra urgami badha. They are tied hand and feet by the laws of nature. Still they are claiming that I am the leader. Suppose, if I want to help you, just like the blind man, I must have eyes. Suppose your hands are tied up. If I want to help you, then my hands must be free. But if my hands are also tied up, how can I help you? It is not possible. So I must be a free man to help you. Your hands are tied up by the laws of nature. Then I must be a free man. I must be free from the laws of nature. Then I can help you. So Krishna is free from the laws of nature. Therefore he can help you. He can, unbind your tightening. Trigunamai means guna. Guna means rope, and also the modes of nature. Devidhisa, gunamai, mumuvaya, virutra. So we are all under the stringent laws of this material nature. See, if we are to get free, we must accept a leader who is free from this material nature. So Krishna is free. Devidhisa, gunamai, mumuvaya, virutra. The material nature is working under his direction. Mayadhakshena prakriti swyate sa characharam, you will find in Bhagavad Gita. The material nature is working under his direction. He is not under the direction of material nature. Therefore, he can be our leader. And nobody else can be. So if you actually want, because by nature we have to follow some leadership. So if we actually want the leadership which will lead us to the perfect goal of life, then we have to follow Krishna. That is a fact. If you don't follow, that depends on our discretion. Just like Arjuna, he was asked by Krishna, now, what you have decided? Are you going to follow me? Oh, you can do whatever you like. I have told you everything. So Krishna is telling us everything in the Bhagavad Gita. Now it is up to us to accept his leadership or not. If we accept his leadership, then we are free from this material bondage. And if we do not accept, then we can do whatever we want. Krishna does not interfere with our independence. That is a fact. Thank you very much. Now if there is any question. You have any doubt in the supreme nature of Krishna?
I wish to understand.
Huh?
I wish to understand.
Of that we are making discussion. That we are making discussion.
Correctly.
Yes. Krishna is accepted as the Supreme by all stalwart past acharyas. Just like Shankaracharya, a great scholar, he also accepts Krishna. Sa Bhagavan Sayam Krishna. Oh, he accepts Krishna, the Supreme Lord. He'll find in his annotation of Bhagavad Gita. Similarly, Sri Ramanucharya, he accepts. And now, Lord Chaitanya, he also preaches this Krishna philosophy, Krishna consciousness. And formally also, great leaders like Vyasadeva, Narad, and even at the present moment, all big leaders of India. I'm speaking especially of India because this Bhagavad Gita was first seen in the Bhagavad Gita in the India, in the Indian plain. Of course, it is not meant for India, it is meant for everyone. Just like the sun rises in the east first, then comes to the west. But that does not mean East has the monopoly of the sun and not the West. Similarly, the sun of Bhagavad Gita might have arisen in the land of India, but that does not mean that it is the monopoly of India. It is meant for everyone. It is meant for everyone. So, it is an accepted authority. Mahajana jena gatasya pankha. So we have to follow great personalities. Yes.
If Krishna is the Supreme Consciousness, then
anything we do or anyone we follow following or doing Krishna consciousness.
Krishna is Supreme Consciousness, that's all right. But you are not Supreme Consciousness. You have to follow the Supreme Consciousness.
If he is Supreme Consciousness, everything I do is Supreme, following that one Supreme Consciousness.
No.
There can be nothing else that exists.
No.
No.
No. We are not following the Supreme Consciousness. Then we have been on the same level. Just like your consciousness, my consciousness is different. Because we do not follow the Supreme Consciousness. Therefore your...
Supreme Consciousness is all.
Supreme Consciousness, yes. Supreme.
All
consciousness is the same as in the Supreme, so also in you, so also in me. The quality of the consciousness is the same. But your consciousness and my consciousness is different.
But that's all part of the same Supreme Consciousness.
No, qualitatively they work. But at the present moment, because we are materially bound up, therefore we find so many different consciousnesses. Do you think that your consciousness and my consciousness is the same?
Yes.
How? Do you agree with me? Do I agree with you?
Sure.
Yes. We do not agree, therefore your consciousness is different, my consciousness is different. When we agree, then it is the same. When you come to the point of agreement, then it is the same.
It's the same even in disagreement.
Eh?
It's the same even in disagreement.
Disagreement?
Because disagreement is a part of the same Supreme.
Oh, then you mean to say disagreement and agreement the same thing? Then I cannot follow you.
That's what I'm trying to understand. The Supreme Consciousness is all consciousness, even disagreement.
Supreme Consciousness, just like you try to understand your consciousness. Are you conscious? You agree?
Yes.
Are you conscious what is going on in me?